Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the DiabetesCouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Now, I want to emphasize that my perspective is coming from one with type 2 diabetes and not type 1. Our channel is primarily for those with type 2 diabetes and pre-diabetes. Today, I want to answer the question, what is fasting blood glucose? After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you'll find anywhere. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes, recipes for different goals such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning tips and tricks, and there are also tons of diabetes-friendly recipes for everyone. One of the first jobs, if you will, you were shown or will be shown how to perform is taking a blood glucose or blood sugar reading. In most cases, you are written a prescription for a machine called a glucometer. Some will call it a glucose meter or a sugar reader. Sometimes your healthcare provider will even have one to give you. Generally, you can get a glucometer kit for free with enough supplies to get started, and then you pay for the test strips and lancets each month or however often you will need them. Now, monitoring your blood glucose daily is simply a vital part of managing diabetes. It also is important because it empowers you to be in charge of your disease. No matter what your treatment plan consists of, blood sugar monitoring gives you immediate feedback into how well your plan is doing. Is it working? Now, you are shooting for a fasting blood glucose level of 80 to 120 each morning. Now, this is called a fasting blood glucose level because you have not eaten in a while, or you have fasted. Now, interestingly enough, the word breakfast means to break the fast. Now, you've learned something whether you wanted to or not. Now, a reading of less than 80 is considered hypoglycemic. It means your blood glucose level is getting too low. In this case, you need to get some carbs in your system, about 15 carbs as a matter of fact, and then recheck your blood sugar levels again. If your readings are extremely high, especially before eating, say in the 180 range, you may need to take something to bring it down. Now, if you have prediabetes, you probably haven't been prescribed any insulin, but that's the best thing to use to bring it down is fast-acting insulin. Your doctor may give you a script for just emergencies. This is something that definitely should be discussed with your doctor and is one of the reasons taking blood sugar readings are so important. This is very important information for you on several levels. You need to know what your readings are to see if you're on the right track. The fasting blood glucose is the best way to find this out, although you may also be directed to check your glucose before or after each meal. Your fasting blood glucose tells your healthcare provider what your body is doing and how it is processing carbs and starches and how well your cells are using the insulin that you make. Don't forget to get my new ebook and please subscribe to our channel for many more videos like this one in the future. I want to thank you so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.